This is a Friday Shoes production. Lesson 2-9 on page 126 in your book. And our target today is I can use powers and exponents in expressions. Let's discuss what a power is. Take a look at the 2 to the 4th power. That's how you read that. It says a product of repeated factors can be expressed as a power. That means multiplying the base by the amount the exponent is. That is using an exponent and a base. So the base is the common factor, and that's the 2. And 4 is the exponent, and that tells how many times the base is used as a factor being multiplied. And you can see 2 to the 4th power is actually 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. And that would be 16. Now, a quick example here that I made. You try it on your own. How do we write this in exponential form? Well, you got 3 to the 3rd power times 4 to the 2nd power. And I put a dot in between to represent multiplication of those two. That's how you write it, simplified. How about this down here? It says, again, write each expression using exponents. I will. Well, how do we do 1 half times 1 half times 1 half? Well, that'll be 1 half. I'll put parentheses around it, and that's the 3rd power because there's 3 of them. And then, of course, you've got times 3 to the, let's see, how many of these? 1, 2, 3, 4. There's 4 of them there. That'd be 3 to the 4th power. There's your answer on that one. How about this one over here? This is algebra now. We just have the letters, but it's the same concept. Let's put the A's together. So we have A times A. Then we'll have times B times B times B, because the commutative property says we can rearrange these. Multiplication is commutative. So we have A to the 2nd power, meaning there's 2 of those, times B to the 3rd power, since there's 3 of those. There's your final answer. You try a couple of them. Well, how about 3 of them? Stop the video. Do these 3. Come on back. See how you did. All right, the first one is 2/3 times by 7 times 2/3 times 2/3 times 7 times 2/3. Well, there's how many 2/3? I see 4 of them. So I'm going to write down 2/3 to the 4th power, which means 2/3 is being used 4 times as a factor. And then times, how many 7s do we have? 7 times 7, only 2 of them. There you go. So writing it using exponents, if you look at the directions, that would be the answer. That's the one using exponents. All right, how about B? We've got a little bit out of order, so let's put them together. So we got M times M times M. There's 3 of them. And then times N times N times N. It looks like we've got 3M's, so it's M to the 3rd power. And we got times, and we've got N to the 3rd power as well. Here's our final answer. And the last one. Keep in mind, I didn't say this earlier, but we will always put our coefficient in front of our letter. So we work with the numbers first. So we have, if we're writing it in exponents, here we go. So we have 1, 2. That's the smallest number there. So that's 2 to the 1st power times, by the way, I said that, 2 to the 1st power is actually just 2. So I will leave off the 1. We just write the 2. We don't have to put the 1 up there. Now let's do our 3. So we've got 2 of those. And this is all just being multiplied. So we've got 2 3s as factors. Then what do we have? We've got an A, it looks like. I'm going to go now to the letters and do it in alphabetical order. How many of those? We had 2 of those. And then we got to the final thing, which is 1B. So that's what it would look like. 2 times 3 to the 2nd power times A to the 2nd power times B. That is our final answer. Let's take a look at our negative exponents. It says exponents can also be negative. It says consider the pattern in the powers of 10 here in the chart to show you how this looks. Negative powers are the result of repeated division. Notice when we did the power being positive, we were multiplying. This is division. And the one thing I want to point out to you is you can see the pattern as it goes down from here. It travels down here. You can start at the top. 10 to the 3rd power is 10 times 10 times 10, which is actually 1,000. If you divide by 10, if you follow the little chart here now, if you divide by 10, you get down to 10 to the second power. 10 to the second power is 10 times 10. 10 to the first power is 10. 10 to the zero power is 1. You can just see what's happening. You're just dividing by 10 here each time. But the main thing I want to point out is take a look at these negative exponents here. So we got 10 to the negative 1 and 10 to the negative 2. And notice what those are over here. Well, 10 to the negative 1 is 1 over 10. And 10 to the negative 2 is 1 over 100. And I want you to take a look at these two as in comparison. You got 10 and 1 over 10. You've got 100 and 1 over 100. You remember what those are called? Well, I hope you do. They're reciprocals or multiplicative inverses. So the negative sign in an exponent actually means the reciprocal of that particular value. So 10 to the first power is 10, but 10 to the negative first power is 1 over 10, which would be the flip of 10. It does not mean a negative answer. And that is what most kids and people learning this think. And if you read the tip over here, it even says that. It says negative exponents. Remember that 10 to the negative 2, they're using that as an example, 10 to the negative 2 equals 1 over 10 to the second power, which is 1 over 100. It does not equal, and I'll say this and highlight it, does not equal negative 100 or negative 20. A lot of wrong, those are wrong answers, typical wrong answers. So, in a nutshell, zero and negative exponents, it says any non-zero number to the zero power is 1. And this is something you just have to memorize. 5 to the 0 is 1. 6 to the 0 power is 1. 7 to the 0 power is 1. 1 to the 0 power is 1. So any non-zero number to the power of 0 is 1. Just memorize it. Any non-zero number to the negative n power is the multiplicative inverse of its nth power. Well, look at what they're saying here. 7 to the negative third power is actually 1 over, that's kind of like they're flipping it, 1 over 7 to the third power, so whatever that is. Just like 1 to the, or let's say 2 to the negative 3 power is the same as 1 over 2 to the third power. 3 to the negative 7th power is going to be 1 over 3 to the 7th power. Again, they're reciprocals or multiplicative inverses. Take a look at a couple of these examples here. Evaluate 2/3 to the 4th power. Well, that just means 2/3 is going to be a factor 4 times. So what do we do first? Well, let's write it out like that. 2/3 is 4 times being multiplied. Then just multiply the tops and multiply the bottoms. So 2 times 2 times 2 times 2, 16. 3 times 3 times 3 times 3, 16 over 81. What about the second one? Evaluate 4 to the negative third. I know a lot of people will think that the answer is going to be negative, but that is not correct. Here's what you do. First, write 4 to the negative third as its reciprocal, which is 1 over 4 to the third. That's where you get rid of the negative once you flipped it. Put it all over 1. Then do 4 to the third power. 4 to the third power is 4 times 4 times 4, which is 64. So final answer is 4 to the third power. And I want you to think about this. 4 to the negative third power is 1 over 64. Do you see a negative in this answer? No. So just because we have a negative exponent, don't think there's a negative answer. It actually does not mean anything to do with negative. The actual symbol should say it means reciprocal. So when you see a negative exponent, think reciprocal, not negative answer. How about the algebra one they have there in the book? Example 5, a squared times b to the fourth power if a is 3 and b is 5. Well, all we have to do is plug and chug, as I call it. Take the a and the b values, put them in, and that's what they do first. They take the a and b out, and they put the 3 and the 5 in. Next step, calculate what 3 to the second power is. That's 9. And 5 to the fourth power, 5 times 5 times 5 times 5. Let's see here. I believe that's 625. All right, so you got your 9 and your times 625. And then, of course, that equals 5,625. So when we evaluate these, just repeat that multiplication. 3 to the second means 3 times 3. 5 to the fourth means 4 fives, and then multiply them. Try these three down at the bottom here, and these are the last ones we're going to do. All right, so 1/15 to the third power is 1/15 multiplied by itself 3 times. So I got to do 1 times 1 times 1, which is equal to 1. And then 15 times 15 times 15. Now, I know that 15 times 15 is 225. And then I multiply that by 5. Here, let me carry this over. We got 2, carry the 1. So we got that. Then we do the 225. There we go. So we got 5, 7. That's a 2. And 3 and 3. So 3375. So the final answer would be this. Because it wants you to actually evaluate the expression, not just write it with exponents. How about E, 5 to the negative 4th power? Well, 5 to the negative 4th power does not mean negative answer. It means 1 over 5 to the 4th power, the reciprocal of that. So what is 5 to the 4th power? Well, that's this number. I think the last example we did that, this actually equals 625. So the final answer is 1 over 625. 1/625. Small amount. And of course, our last one here. We got c to the third power times d to the second power when c is negative 4 and d is 9. So let's plug those in first. So c is negative 4, so I'll plug negative 4 in for c and multiply or raise that to the power of 3. And then d is 9 and raise that to the power of 2. Now, negative 4 to the third power. The negative is on the number part, not on the exponent. So it's actually negative 4 times negative 4 times negative 4. And then that multiplied by 9 times 9, whatever that is. 4 times 4 times 4. I get 16 here. When I do negative 4 times negative 4, that's 16. And I take that and multiply by negative 4. 4 16s is 64. It's going to be negative because I've got a negative. Now we do the times, and then we do know what 9 times 9 is. That's 81. So it's going to be negative 64. Do that on your own and get the correct answer. Don't forget, you can always request the video to check out more information and review. And you can read the examples in the book. They're very similar to the ones I just did because they are from the book. And you can also watch the tutor videos on our online textbook. And as usual, this has been a Friday Shoes production.